We present Dixon of Dock Green, with David Calder as PC George Dixon, David Tennant as PC Andy Crawford, and Charlie Brooks as Mary Dixon. Roaring Boy, dramatised by Sue Rodwell from the television screenplay by Ted Willis.
Evening, all. I was just thinking about something that happened the other day. Made me laugh. This American fella came up. Asked me the way to Marble Arch. We got chatting, like you do. I asked him where he was from. Turns out he came from Chicago. I was ribbing him about Al Capone when he asks me where I keep my gun. Straight up. He wouldn't believe it when I told him English police don't carry him. He wanted to know what I'd do if I came up against a bloke with a shooter. Well, as a matter of fact, I was able to tell him exactly what I'd do. The look on his face. I had to laugh. Not that it was the least bit funny at the time.
All right, Andy. Looks like you'll be waving your arms around for a couple of hours.
What do you mean?
Flint says the traffic lights in Weber Street have packed up. Wants you up there pretty sharpish.
No, not again.
Sorry, lad.
No, you're not.
No, I'm not. But I'll be thinking of you while I'm enjoying my afternoon off.
No, thanks. George.
What?
Nothing,
There's something on your mind, Andy.
No, it's not important.
Well, you've been like a cat on hot tiles all morning.
Sorry.
Well, drink up your tea. We'd better get off before Flint finds something else for us to do.
Right. It'll start to rain in a minute, you'll see.
Only on you, Andy. I was thinking of going up the canal for a spot of fishing. Once I've dealt with this little bit of business...
What business is that?
Well, it's nothing much. Lad's gone absent without leave. Flint wants me to check up on his girlfriend before I'm off for the day. Well, it's just routine. I'll drop by on my way home. Then the afternoon's my own.
You got a good little room here, Di.
Glad you like it.
Nice things. The mirror. This rug.
Yeah, and you can take your dirty boots off it.
Ooh, sorry.
Don't know why my mum told you where he was.
Because she likes me. Maybe she thinks we should get together again. What's behind the curtain?
The kitchen, if you can call it that.
Well, make us a cup of tea, then.
Make it yourself.
How much does it all cost you a week?
None of your business.
Proper wardrobe, too. I have to keep my stuff in a tin box.
Shut up or you'll break me up.
Ooh, these clothes. You buy these yourself?
Of course I did.
Is this real silk?
Think I could afford that.
I'd buy you proper silk dresses.
Leave it, Doug. Leave my things alone.
You sure it was you who bought all these?
Who else?
Bert?
I told you, I don't see Bert no more.
But do I believe you?
I don't care if you believe me or not. When are you going?
You were happy enough to let me in.
Didn't know you were on the run then, did I?
Come on, Di. Be friendly.
If the cops find you here, I'll be in real trouble.
They won't find me. Not unless you tell them. You wouldn't do that.
Don't be so sure.
I know you wouldn't.
Think a lot of yourself, don't you?
Because if you did tell them, darling, I'd spoil your looks.
You and whose army?
Oh, don't talk to me about the army. I've had them up to here. You got good looks, Di.
Shut up.
Nice skin. Satin.
Hands off.
I remember when you wanted me to touch you.
All I want is to know when you're going to get out.
Not just yet. It's bucketing down out there.
Why? That's all I want to know. Why me?
All right, move then! Drivers!
Andy!
You look like a drowned rat.
I warn you, Mary, if you laugh, I will never speak to you again.
Oh, well, we're going to have a very dull life then. I was going to treat you to lunch at the Magpie later, but if that's the way things are...
Oh, well, wait. No, not you. Mary!
I'll see you at the Magpie 1 o'clock. Oh, and I'll bring a towel.
Go on, Di.
You are joking, aren't
you? No! That's why I'm here. I want you to come away with me.
Don't be stupid.
I've got money.
It'll take more money than you've ever had.
I'll get plenty more.
How are you going to do that?
There are ways.
You're going to rob a bank?
I might.
I thought the army would make you grow up a bit. Don't you see, Doug? I'm not interested in your money. I've got a good job. Prospects.
Prospects?
Yeah.
Yeah, what? 9 to 5 till you're too old to have any fun, then draw your pension till you kick the bucket. Is that what you mean?
I'm going out. You be gone when I get back, or I will tell the cops.
You'd never do that. Not the cops.
Just go.
You used to be fond of me, Di.
I must have been crackers.
We had some times, didn't we?
Suppose we did.
Why don't you get out of this dump?
You said it was a nice room.
I was lying, it's a dump. Come away with me.
What's the point? Half the police in London must be after you. They'll find you, take you away. Where does that leave me?
That's what I'm saying. Let's you and me get out of here first.
Where to?
South Coast. One of them holiday camps. Anywhere. They won't catch me.
What sort of a life do you call that? Dodging every cop you see, waiting for a knock at the door. No thanks.
We'd have a great time, Di. The two of us. We fit. Always have, haven't we? Come on. Give us a kiss.
Get off.
Who's that?
How should I know?
Well, don't open the door.
It's my door.
Shut up.
Miss Johnson?
Has he gone?
You think I've got x-ray eyes?
Shh.
Miss Johnson? I'm a police officer. I'd like to have a word with you.
Get in the kitchen.
Oh, don't let him in.
He's not going away till I talk to him.
If you tell him I'm here.
Shut up, Doug, and do as you're told.
Your landlady said you were in, so if I could have a word.
Won't be a mo. Don't make a sound, or we'll hear you through the curtain.
Well, get rid of him, quick.
I'm coming. Just putting on a dressing gown. Sorry, I was in bed. Had a bit of an headache.
I'm sorry to disturb you, miss.
What's all this about?
Well, I'm making inquiries into the whereabouts of a soldier. Fusilier Douglas Beale. I believe you know him.
Doug? What's he been up to?
Perhaps if I could come in.
Yeah, of course. How rude of me.
I won't keep you long.
Don't worry about that. I've got the old day off work. Cigarette?
No, thanks, miss.
Don't mind if I do.
Of course not. Oh, nice little place, this.
It's not bad for a single room. Bit damp, mind you. Keep having to scrub mould off the wall. Actually, it's a dump.
Is it the kitchen behind that curtain?
Yeah, it's only a cubbyhole, really. So, what do you want Doug for?
Well, he's deserted from his army unit.
Typical.
Well, it doesn't surprise you.
Doug never liked being told what to do. Couldn't believe it when he joined up.
Well, maybe there was a spot of bother in Doc Green he wanted to get away from.
That'd be Doug all over, out of the frying pan. And he was probably drunk when he signed the papers.
Have you seen him in the last few days?
Oh, I haven't seen him for months.
Well, he's not been in touch then, written to you?
Hardly, seeing as he can't write.
So you've no idea where he might be?
No.
You're quite sure?
Of course I am. But now I think of it, Doug did talk about some pal of his up north. He might have gone there.
Oh, how far up north?
I'm trying to remember. Carlisle, that was it.
You wouldn't know the name of this pal.
Sorry, I really can't help you. Well, suppose I'd better be getting ready for work.
Well, you said you had the day off.
Morning off. I'm going to be late.
Oh, where is it you work?
Want to check up on me, do you?
Oh, it's just a routine question for my report.
I work at Marley's in Victoria Road. We sell frocks and things.
Good job, is it?
Pays the rent. Look, I'm really going to have to ask you to go unless you want to watch me getting dressed.
Do you have many visitors here, miss? Men friends?
What do you mean?
Well, I couldn't help noticing the cap on that chair.
That? Bert must have left it.
Bert?
Just a friend of mine. Not against the law, is it, having men friends?
No, it's not against the law.
I am over 21, you know.
Would you mind if I took a look in that kitchen of yours?
As a matter of fact, I would. It's a terrible mess.
Well, there wouldn't be another reason.
Of course not. What do you mean?
Well, I can put up with a bit of mess.
Please don't.
And who have we here?
You won't take no for an answer, will you, copper?
Well, that depends, sir.
Sir? I like that. Bit of respect.
Don't start.
What's your name?
I don't have to tell you.
It's Reg. Reg Coppard. He's a friend of mine.
That's right.
And you've been hiding there all this time?
My landlady doesn't like me having men friends in the room. Thought you might tell her.
Well, the only friend of yours I'm interested in is Douglas Beale. Do you know him, Mr. Coppard?
Beale? I don't think so.
But you're not in the army with him.
Army? I don't know what you mean.
Your boots, sir. Look like army issue to me.
But these? They're my brother's. I borrowed them.
Do you have any proof of identity?
Not on me, why?
I have reason to believe that you are Fusilier Douglas Beale.
Doug.
back.
Oh, thanks, Di.
I'm putting you under arrest, Beale.
Yeah?
You'll be taken before a magistrate tomorrow and then remanded in custody for military escort.
Got it all worked out?
I told you, Doug. I said they'd get you.
They haven't yet.
Now, come on, son.
Don't call me son.
Now, just come along with me, nice and quietly.
You put your hand on me again, copper, and I'll shoot it off.
Doug!
Now, don't be stupid.
Where did you get there?
I'm a soldier, love. Lots of guns around, yeah? I took this off a creep called Lieutenant Phillips just after I thumped him. Tried to put me on jankers.
Give it to me, Bill.
Oh, wouldn't you like that? Sit down.
Please, Doug.
Shut up.
You can't.
Shut up. Give us your handcuffs, copper.
I don't have them with me.
Don't make me laugh. Take off your coat.
There you are. No cuffs, no truncheon. Left them at the station. I was on my way home when I called in here. Oh, looking forward to putting my feet up.
I don't want to hear your life story.
Look, son.
Will you stop calling me that? Sir, that's what I like. All right.
Now, don't make this any worse than it is already.
I said sit down. If you won't do as you're told...
Now, give me the gun. We can talk sensibly.
Right, you asked for it. Turn around.
Doug, don't be silly.
You two, both of you, turn around and face the wall.
Now, you're just making things worse for yourself.
Do it.
All right, Bill. All right. All right, calm down. Calm down. We'll sit quietly and talk.
No talking.
What are you going to do?
Second thoughts. You can turn around and look at me. You might as well see what's coming to you. Be more fun that way. For me, at least. Now, ladies first. That's only polite.
Don't do this, Beale.
I'm going to count to three.
Please, Doug.
You can't shoot us.
I think I can, copper. I'm the one with the gun.
The noise will bring half the police force in Dock Green down on your neck.
One.
Now, Beale.
You want to be the first, copper, because you're going the right way about it.
You won't do it. You won't shoot me.
No. One.
I'll go away with you.
Too late. Two.
Please, Doug, don't.
Three. Bang!
Did that make you feel like a big man, Bill?
Matter of fact, it did. I can see we're going to have some fun, copper.
Wasn't any beef left, so I got us both fish and chips.
Oh, that's fine. But I was going to treat you.
I'm not having you pay for lunch. Anyway, it's time I provided a meal for once.
Mm, that's true. And no washing up. I think I could get used to this.
Don't you dare. Mm. I've seen the prices they charge here.
Mm. Aren't I worth it?
Every penny. But just not too often.
So, what did Dad say?
Poor old George. He won't get much fishing done in this rain.
Andy?
We had a busy morning.
You haven't talked to him yet, have you?
Not exactly.
How not exactly?
Well, not at all. I couldn't find the right moment.
Well, then I'll tell him this evening.
No, that's my job. I want to do it properly.
Are you all this old-fashioned in Scotland?
I'm probably the only one.
And what if my dad tells you no daughter of his is going to marry a policeman, let alone a Scotsman?
Well, then we'll have to elope. Obviously.
You can't keep us here forever, you know.
I can do what I like, so long as I'm the one with the shooter.
Just leave him, Mr. Dixon. He's not worth talking to.
So what's your plan, Bill?
Plan?
Well, you're not telling me you don't know what you're going to do next. Or are we going to be stuck here forever while you wave that gun about?
Maybe I'm not going to keep you here.
But if you're going to let us go, you may as well do it now.
I didn't say anything about letting you go. You ought to listen, copper. Or should I shoot a hole through your head, make it easier for you to hear?
Please, Doug, don't muck about.
You think I'm mucking about, do
you? If you've got anything to say, Doug, I'm listening.
No, you're not. You're thinking, how can I get the better of this idiot? Isn't that right? Well, I'm not an idiot.
I know you're not.
I'm trying to smarm now. You get a uniform and you'll reckon you're so clever, but I can see right through you.
Well, you had a uniform.
I can't stand this.
Shut up, Di. Shut up or I really will shoot you. Keep it down. I don't want anyone else knocking on the door. One visitor's enough for today. Yeah, I was only joking, love. If I wanted to shoot you, I'd have done it. You believe me, don't you?
Of course.
You're like a yo-yo, Di. Up, down, up, down. One minute all talk, the next you're wobbling like one of those jellies we used to have at school. Remember them?
I just want this to be over.
It will be. One way or another. Now, what were we saying, copper? Oh, yeah, uniforms. Mine didn't have any stripes, so any jumped-up corporal thought he could tell me what to do. I wasn't having that.
Well, if you stuck at it, maybe you'd be the one giving orders someday.
Well, I'm giving them now. Stand up.
Why?
Because I'll tell you to. It's an order.
Leave him alone, can't you?
No, it's all right, miss. I could do with stretching my legs.
That's it. Now, sit down again.
Stop it, Doug. You'd stop it.
No, come to think of it, stand up.
Oh, don't push your luck, Bill. I might call your bluff.
You think I'm bluffing? All I have to do is squeeze the trigger.
Well, then go ahead, lad.
Look, Doug, I'll go away with you, like you want.
Not so sure I do want to anymore.
Let's go right now. I'll get dressed, pack a bag, we'll be off and free.
And what do we do with him?
But leave him here.
Dead, you mean?
No.
But he knows what we're going to do.
He won't say anything. Isn't that right, mister?
My name's George Dixon.
Trying to get friendly with us. That won't work.
You won't say anything, will you, Mr. Dixon? He'll promise, Doug.
I'm afraid I can't make any promises.
Of course you can.
No, miss.
See? Coppers. Never give an inch. Especially stupid ones like him.
What makes you think I'm stupid, son?
Don't see any stripes on your jacket. Shouldn't you be a sergeant by now, at your age? Well?
I never wanted to be stuck behind a desk. I'm happier on the beat. Get to meet all sorts that way. Got to meet you.
I bet you wish you hadn't.
You could be quite sure about that.
At least you're not trying to be polite. I respect that, copper.
Why don't you get it over with, Doug?
What's that, love?
If you're going to shoot us, do it.
Told you, I'm not going to shoot you. Not unless you annoy me. Him, he's another matter altogether. He's a problem.
Look, Doug...
Did I say you could call me Doug?
Think this through, will you?
How do you mean, George? I can call you George, can't I, seeing as we're all being so friendly now?
You can let me go, or you can shoot me.
Thank you, but I don't need your permission.
And if you kill me... Oh. And if you kill me, then what? You won't get out of this building, because the whole place will be crawling with police in 2 seconds
flat. So you said before, and I wasn't much impressed then.
It'll mean the rope, for sure.
You don't get it, do you? I've got 3 bullets in this gun. One for you, one for her, and one for me.
You said you wouldn't shoot me.
I did, didn't I? The trouble is, every time you open your stupid mouth, I change my mind.
You don't want to kill yourself.
Yes, he does.
Please, miss.
What's he got to live for? Loser.
You're both young.
No, she's right. Got myself into a bit of a pickle here, and it's all your fault, George. To be honest, I don't see a way out.
It's not too late.
If you hadn't come knocking on that door, me and Di would be on our way to Brighton, but now I'm looking at, what, 10 years inside? Kidnapping a cop, it must be a 10-year stretch at least.
I can put in a good word for you.
You expect me to believe that?
If I say I'll do something, I'll do it.
Thought you couldn't make promises.
Why don't you listen to him, Doug? Listen to someone else for once in your life.
Will you shut up, Di? Yeah, the trouble is, I don't want to spend 10 days inside, let alone 10 years. You can't swing that for me, can you? George? I thought not. Let's have some music, Di. Help me think this out.
Why not? Have a sing-along.
You still got a record we bought? Al Martino it was, here in my heart. Very romantic. It's
there somewhere. Take a look.
Ah, here it is. We bought this together, George. Christmas 51 it was. Of course, that was when I thought me and Di had a future.
Just put it on and shut up.
Cheer up, darling. Might never happen. I'd ask you to dance with me, Di. Only I'd have to put the gun down.
Don't worry, I'm not heartbroken.
What about you two?
Don't be stupid.
No. Wouldn't you like that? George? Dance with a pretty girl? Can't happen too often at your age.
Why don't you just leave us alone?
Because this is too much fun. Go on.
I'd like to dance. If you don't mind, Miss Johnson.
Oh, don't mind. And it's Diana.
That's so romantic. I'm all broke up.
Here in my arms, I long to hold you. Hold you so near.
Dad!
Looks like he's not here.
Dad!
He wants to get out.
You sound relieved.
Of course I'm not.
Putting off the evil hour?
There is that, of course.
Honestly, it's typical of Dad. He's never here when you want him.
My daughter's about your age.
Is she? You're married then?
A widower.
Sorry.
Oh, it's all right. Happened during the war. I wasn't the only one by a long chalk.
So what's your daughter's name?
Mary.
Nice. How old was she when she lost her mum?
13.
Poor kid. Must have been hard for both of you.
Hang on.
What?
I think Bill's asleep.
Wouldn't you like to?
Ignore him, Mr. Dixon.
It's George, please.
Aww.
Doesn't seem right, Sam, eh, calling you by a Christian name.
You think it's going to worry me, you two palling up together?
Got any grandchildren?
Not yet. But something tells me it won't be too long.
It's a pity you won't get to see them.
I'd have liked kids.
Well, it's not too late. You're young yet.
Yeah. Trouble is, you need a man, don't you? And I've never met one who's halfway decent.
If you're trying to annoy me, love, you're going the right way about it.
Funnily enough, Doug, you were the best of a bad bunch.
Thanks.
But you're all out for one thing. Even old Marley. He tried to make me think he was giving me a job out of the goodness of his heart. That's a laugh. Spends most of his time chasing me around the shop, slobbering.
You don't have to stay there, do you?
I'll stay as long as I can keep him on a hook. Take all I can get from him.
Nah, that's not very nice.
He's loaded. He can afford it. He's paid for most of the stuff in here. The good stuff, one way or another.
You see, Copper? She's not the pure little innocent you think she is.
It's getting late, Bill. They'd be wondering where I am down at the station.
You're sweating. Scared, are you?
Very.
So would you be if you didn't have that gun.
You think I'm yellow?
I think you're pathetic.
It's sad that this place will be the last thing you see. Bit of tatty wallpaper and second-hand rubbish.
I'm not frightened of you.
Aren't you?
No.
Then why are you shaking?
It's cold. You know something, Mr. Dixon?
What's that?
When I told Doug I wasn't going to see him no more, he cried.
Shut up.
Curled up into a little ball and sobbed his heart out.
Shut up, Di.
What if I don't? Go on, Doug. Do it.
So help me, if you don't shut your mouth.
Go on.
Right. I will.
Beale.
Stay where you are,
Copper. If you shoot, there's no going back. Do you understand?
Don't close your eyes, Di. I want you looking at me when it happens. See the smile on my face. Feel the barrel up against your skin. It's cold, isn't it? That's steel, that is. No. I just squeeze the trigger. Nice and slow. Eyes open. Nice and slow. Oh, typical. Pick her up and put her on that chair.
You were gonna shoot her.
Yeah. But it's no fun if she's not watching while I do it. Where are you going?
Get her some water.
You stay there. She doesn't need water. I'll tell you something. I need a drink. Keep my hands steady. I wonder where she keeps the whiskey. Nah, it'll be gin. Nice gin and tonic. That was always Di's tipple. You want a drink, Copper?
A cup of tea would go down nicely.
Yeah, too bad you're not going to be around long enough for the kettle to boil. Don't shift from that chair either, Copper.
Miss Johnson. Miss Johnson.
Where's she keep it? The mess in here.
Diana.
What is it?
Oh, come on. Wake up.
I'm not dead, then.
She's always been a bit of a slut, Di.
Listen to me. You've got to distract Bill.
I can't.
Diane, you must. Make him turn his back on me.
Got it. Cheap muck, mind you. Hello, Di. Woken up, then?
Yeah. I'm all right now.
I'll make you a gin and tonic. Only it'd be such a waste, wouldn't it, considering?
You really going to kill me this time?
Once I've got a drink or two inside me. You're very quiet, Copper.
Nothing left to say to you, son.
Well, I'll tell you what. If I'm going to be killed, it won't be in this old dressing gown.
What are you doing?
I'm going to choose a dress.
Sit down.
You can pick it for me, Doug.
You're on potty?
Now, what have I got in here? Sure to be something you like.
Will you sit down?
What about this one?
Don't push it, love.
Think I look pretty in blue? Or, what about purple? You used to like me in purple.
Will you sit down, you stupid cow?
Dan, you're hurting.
I'll do more than that.
Now you drop that gun, Bill.
It's breaking my arm.
Good.
Pick up the gun, miss.
My pleasure.
Give it here, Di.
You are joking.
I'll take it.
I could shoot you right now, Doug. Pay you back for putting us through all this.
Go on, then. Do it.
The gun, please.
All right.
Oh, thank you.
You bowled out?
I wouldn't spend 2 seconds in jail on your account, Doug.
You did well.
I did, didn't I?
Now, you take this whistle, open that window, and give it 3 good blasts.
I always wanted to do that.
I'm worried, Andy.
Ah, you know your dad. He's probably at the club.
It's not open yet.
Then he'll be playing darts down the King's Arms.
He usually leaves me a note if he's not going to be in for tea.
Will you expect me to do that?
Of course. I intend to keep you well under my thumb, PC Crawford. Oh, there he is.
Well, I've had quite a day.
Where have you been?
I'm sorry, love. Got held up. I'll tell you all about it over a cup of tea.
In a minute, George. First, I've got something really important to tell you.
Oh, all right, Andy. Fire away.
I don't like seeing people waving guns, whichever side of the law they're on. Another few minutes in that room and I reckon I wouldn't be talking to you now. Last I heard, Doug Beale was in Broadmoor. Well, maybe he'll get the treatment he needs. And Di Johnson? Well, you never guess. Joined the police force. Finished her training not long back. She's based over Camberwell way just now. But I wouldn't be surprised if we didn't see her down Dock Green Station one of these days. She'll make a good copper. And Mary and Andy? Well, that's another story for another day. Evening, all. In the final episode of Dixon of Dock Green, George Dixon was played by David Calder, PC Andy Crawford by David Tennant, and Mary Dixon by Charlie Brooks. Doug Beale was played by Carl Prekop, and Diana by Hayley Doherty. Dixon of Dock Green was dramatised for radio by Sue Rodwell, from the screenplay by Ted Willis, and produced in Bristol by Viv Beebe and Jeremy Howe.